We're owned by the corporate interest. We're owned by the military-industrial congressional complex. We're owned by the financial interest. I mean, you just take your pick of the bogeyman you want to look at that day, and you do not have a leadership in any party that can do much about this. And part of this, of course, is this fascination for war that we've developed, because that's generally what empires in decline do, whether the decline is financial, economic, spiritual, or whatever. And I think our decline is in all those dimensions. The attention begins to go to the management of trouble on the fringes of that empire, to keeping people out interested in the fringes of empire while the rot occurs at the very core. And that's what's happening to us right now.
So in the final analysis, what do you think? Does there need to be an independent inquiry to find out about all of these events?
Well, I'm like the president in this instance for different reasons. I hate to waste such treasure and energy and time on something that's not going to be acted on, or not acted on in any way that's going to be helpful. If we're just looking for
catharsis. Well, it could be acted on by Americans who can say, well, we're not going to vote for this whole gang anymore.
Oh, au contraire.
This whole gang.
We don't have that choice anymore. We get two idiots to vote for every year whose campaigns say all manner of things, but whose actual actions are not, I'll quote Ralph Nader here virtually, are not any different from Tom and Jerry. I mean, the two of them are going to do the same thing, because basically what we have today is a corporatocracy. We have the presidents and the Congress in the hands of big food, big pharmacy, big oil, finance, insurance, and real estate. Look at Tim Geithner and Larry Summers. They are quintessential representatives of those communities. And that's who runs this country now. The president doesn't run this country. The Secretary of Defense and Secretary of State don't run these people. And God help us, the American people don't run this country. Big money runs this country.